The other students and I decided to build this model because there seemed to be a lot of misconceptions about relief wells, how they function and what they are. The interesting thing about this model is that it's actually very similar to what BP is performing in the Gulf of Mexico right now with the Macondo well. All right, this is the LSU relief well model. The blue portion at the top represents a body of water such as the Gulf of Mexico. The brown portion represents the earth. The horizontal pipe at the bottom represents the reservoir. And we're using water to represent oil and compressed air to represent natural gas. The vertical tubing in the center there represents our primary well. This is generally drilled to produce the petroleum fluids from the reservoir. The tubing on the left-hand side is our relief well, and this is where we will be pumping our heavy drilling fluid to control our blown-out well. That is the top hat. The top hat is nothing more than how we connect our surface equipment to the well itself. What we're looking at now is the junction of our relief well and the primary well. What you're seeing is the water and the gas flowing, which of course represents our oil and natural gas being produced. The gauge at the bottom represents our bottom hole pressure of our primary well. Now, as we add the drilling fluid, you'll see the needle increase. And as the bottom hole pressure increases, it stifles the flow of petroleum fluids. And eventually we'll hit the point where the flow stops entirely or the system begins to run backwards. Now we'll add some drilling fluid and see if we can control this flow. All right, drilling fluid is now mixing with our reservoir fluids, increasing the density of the reservoir fluid mixture. And now our well has been entirely controlled. Once the flow has been controlled, we can then pump cement down the wellbore. This will create a permanent plug and prevent any more flow from being produced.